Just over 24 hours on from the horrific stabbing at Bondi Junction, the nation is in shock. Today, police have revealed what they know about the man behind the attacks and about those who tried to stop him.
It was an attack from out of the blue. Shoppers at Westfield in Bondi Junction unexpectedly subjected to a terrifying rampage that left six people dead and 12 more hospitalised.
It may be some time before we can identify all of the victims because some family members do not reside in Australia.
People hid inside shops as a knife-wielding man engaged in a stabbing spree, his motive as yet unknown. The attacker identified as 40-year-old Queensland man, Joel Couchy.
We are aware that this individual has suffered from mental health. The person involved in the horrific crime has acted alone, and there's no ongoing threat to our community.
Among the victims, 38-year-old Ashley Good, who died in the act of saving her 9-month-old daughter, currently in a serious but stable condition. 25-year-old Dawn Singleton, the daughter of lawyer Julie Martin and businessman John Singleton, also lost her life. Jade Young, architect and mother of two, and security guard Faraz Tahir.
We are working through the process now of speaking with the families and supporting the families of those victims.
Amid the tragedy, stories of heroism. Inspector Amy Scott, who was in the area, received the call and responded immediately. She confronted Couchy, witnesses saying she told him to drop the knife. When he didn't, she opened fire. He died at the scene.
Inspector Amy Scott, who ran towards danger, showed professionalism and bravery, and without a shadow of a doubt, saved many, many lives.
There were acts of courage too from civilians. One man, identified as Silas Despero, grabbing a bollard to confront the attacker as he came up the escalator. Two brothers helping save the life of Ashley Good's baby when she thrust her into their hands.
We were just shopping, saw the man run up to the woman with the baby, and then we were both ready to go and help out.
That bravery was quite extraordinary that we saw yesterday. The best of Australians amidst this extraordinary tragedy.
Bondi rescue star Andy Reid was also there, locked inside the Meyer store when he asked to be let out to help provide first aid to victims.
I thought, I've got to help, so I went to go out and the guy stopped me and said, mate, you can't go. And I said, mate, I'm a lifeguard, I need to go and help that lady.
A day of unimaginable tragedy, also bringing the very best of humanity.
Yohan Phillip was working at a luggage store at Bondi Junction when the terrifying attack unfolded and he was helping people to safety. Yohan, this was the first day of school holidays. The place was absolutely packed. When did you first notice that something terrible was happening?
Yeah, I mean, I was standing there kind of just... A few people had kind of run past, and it happens now and then where kids kind of just muck around and run past at Bondi Junction. But somebody ran past, it was kind of fine, and up until a lady ran past, who was probably 50, ran into the store and said, run, I was kind of like, this is a bit odd. So I grabbed the doors of the store and I was going to close it, and we were trying to just look to see what was happening. We couldn't really see anything. And then we came back out, and as I was coming out to the doors, another lady comes up running. Her name was Margaret, now I know. She bangs on the door and says, let me in. And I kind of pause and I was like, I've got to let her in, of course. Unlock the door. She comes in, and as she's coming in, the attacker falls behind her. And a knife, probably the size of my forearm, kind of falls. I look at this guy who's next to me, James, who was a customer locked in the store with me. And we just go, whoa. And we quickly pull her in, lock the door. He stands up and we're like, I don't know if he's going to see us. I don't know what's going to happen. And he didn't. He stands up very casually, pretty calmly, runs past the store down to the corner and just... A lady just completely... Yeah. And then we kind of looked up and realised that the two security guards that had walked past us minutes ago, just kind of unassumingly unsure what happened, were also both on the floor right in front of us. And I think one of them has since died as well. But I saw a photo today of him, like, in front of a surfboard. And to be honest, him in person looked about 25 kilos lighter. I was like, that's not the same guy. But, seemed pretty calm. And, like, he was sort of lightly jogging as he was carrying out this thing. And it was pretty odd to see him, run past. There's a weird stillness to him, to be honest. But just quite an aggression when he was brandishing the knife and doing what he did.
And so I think there was something like six of you in the back of the store hiding. Mm. What happened then? Because I understand there was a nurse in there.
Yes.
Who wanted to help.
Yeah, oh, gosh, I mean, at the moment this was happening, after we let Margaret in, I locked the door, we went at the back, we saw the security guard who had been just in front of us in the cafe, and this lady, I still don't know her name, I know she was wearing a pink top, she said, I'm a nurse, I can go on and help, and I said, I'm not going to open this door. If I open this door, I don't know if I can let you back in, and I don't know if he's going to come in, I don't know if he's going to come after you, just stay here and wait, let's just wait. And she was pretty frantic, and of course, she, again, I don't know how straight she was thinking. She said, I got to go, I can help, I can help. I said, all right, if I open this door, I don't know if I can let you back in. I just don't know what's going to happen. So open the door, let her out. She ran up to the guy. At that point, a police officer also had run past, and two members of the public were also assisting him. And I think she's fine. She made it out alive. But, yeah, it was an odd kind of... Too many moral dilemmas for one day, I tell you.
Yohan, you also encountered the heroes who were looking after the baby of Ashley Good.
Oh.
What can you tell us about that?
Oh, my gosh. I tell you, those three guys, we were escorted out after about an hour and we were downstairs kind of waiting to give a statement, and these guys came up and explained it. I'm feeling just, yeah, it's weird just, yeah, talking about that. The three English dudes, I think they were tourists, mid-50s. The mum had... after the baby had been stabbed through the pram, she had run over to give the baby to these gents whilst she was taking damage from the attacker. And my understanding is that he held the baby's side as it was bleeding. The back of our store, we can look out into the street, and we saw the baby getting rolled out, and everybody was just like, at that point, we were like, this is something else. And like, I've got footage of that, and it's just like, it's so insane to watch a little kid, you know, 9-month-old, to kind of go through that. But these guys, three grown men, were all just beside themselves. Like, there's no real way to explain how that is. It's very, very, very odd.